Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video tutorial, I'll explain how easy it is to create and configure the SyncFusion React menu bar using the Create React App command. You can use the React menu bar as a navigation header for your web application or site. I will show you how to configure this control with basic features like data binding, adding icons and separator, multi-level nesting, and changing its orientation. Let's start with the application creation process. First, I create an app using the Create React App toolchain, use VS Code as the editor, and show the output in the Chrome browser. Now, I'll create a new application in the command prompt, using the npx create react app command, and provide the app name, My React App. I set the script version to template TypeScript. Then navigate to the desired location and run this example using the npm start command. Now, I can edit the app.tsx page to show the menu bar. Next, I open the project in VS Code and remove the default code snippets from the app.tsx file. I remove the styles from the app.css file and import the material theme CSS styles to apply them to the menu bar component. Then, I install the package using the npm install SyncFusion EJ2 React Navigations command. To start using the component, I import it from the EJ2 React Navigations package and include the menu component tag. Data can be bound to the menu using the items property. Here, I can bind hierarchical data, complex data, and self-referential data. Let me show them one by one. First, to bind hierarchical data to a menu, I create a constant variable, menu items, of type menu item model, and create the list of menu items. Then, I include the text property to specify the caption and set its value to file. Now, I include the items property to specify the sub items and create a sub menu item list with the text property. Similarly, I define other menu items also. Notice here that the view menu has a submenu item, toolbars, which has nested items like menu bar, etc. Then I assign this menu items list to the items property of the menu. See now, menu is rendered with the specified items. When I hover over the file menu item, its sub-items are displayed in the menu pop-up. I can also add icons as a prefix to the menu items, to provide visual representation of an action using the icon CSS property. Here I add the icon for item, file. I open the app.css file and write the font face CSS rules to specify the icon details like font family, source, etc. Then assign this font family to the menu icon. And define the icon class e-file and set its content. Then I assign this class name to the icon CSS property of its corresponding menu item. As you can see, an icon is displayed for the file menu item in the output. Next, I'll show you how to add a separator to the menu. Below the save item, I add another item with the separator property and set its value to true. Check now, separator is added after the item, save. Now I'll show you how to bind a complex data source by mapping the fields using the menu's fields property. I declare a variable, complex data. Here, I'll list the continents and its countries with language details in the submenu. First, I type the field continent and set its value to Asia. Then type the field countries and create another list. I add country field and set its value to India. Here I'm going to show a sub-item to India. I create another list with languages field. I am sure you are familiar with this concept. Yes, it's nothing but multi-level nesting. Now, include the language field and set its value to English. In the same way, I construct other nested items. I have constructed the continent Africa with nested items. And few other continents. Now, I have constructed a complex data source. I assign this complex data to the items property. Then I need to map the parent and child fields to the menu bar using the fields property. I map the text as continent, country, and language. Then, map the children as countries and languages. See the output. When I hover over Asia, menu pop-up with Asian countries will be displayed. When I again hover over India, the pop-up with the Indian languages is shown. Next, I will show you how to bind self-referential data. You can populate menu items using self-referential data structure that contains array of JSON object with parent ID mapping. Here, I declare variable self-data and include the ID property to specify the element ID and set its value to parent 1. I include the text property to specify the display text and set its value to events. Similarly, I define few other items. Here, the first 5 objects are parent menu items, and the next 3 are submenu items of parent 1. Other submenu items are also mapped with their appropriate parents. The last 3 items are further nested, as they act as submenu items of submenu 7. I assign this object to the items property. In the field settings, I map the ID field from self-referential data to the item ID field of menu bar. Also map this field to the parent ID, and this one to text field. Here's the output. When I hover over events, pop-up with sub-items is displayed. On hovering over music, its sub-item is shown. Finally, I'll show you how to change the orientation of menu bar using the orientation property. Here, I include the orientation property and set its value to vertical. See the output. The menu items are aligned vertically. In this video, I have shown you how to create and configure the Syncfusion React menu bar component using the Create React App command and a few of its basic features. You can download this working example from the GitHub link in the description below. I've also shared a link where you can see about obtaining a free license key to use our React products if you're eligible for our community license. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it useful, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel.